Was this the real outcome that you wanted all? I know how much you wanted Sky, and I know, you know, that Comcast went after the other assets, but it seems like that other play made it possible just for everything to work out for Sky. Is this the best outcome for you, or would you have liked the whole thing? I think you always
wanted... This is a time I can say I can't hear you anymore that my feed went out. Look, we're thrilled with the outcome. I'll let you speculate how the journey got us here. Remember, we did bid for Sky before we bid for Fox. I think they're both wonderful companies. What Rupert Murdoch, James Murdoch, Lachlan, and many other people built is a very special company, and that's true with both parts of it. But Sky does look a lot like Comcast, NBC Universal. That subscription model, that market leadership, their brand is better than any media brand in the US or communications brand. They really are a products company, and they have great leadership in Jeremy Darroch, and I'm pleased that he's staying with us and is going to lead Sky and work with Steve Burke and the rest of the team here, with Dave and myself, Mike Cavanaugh, and we're going to drive a company that's so unique and now global. It's an exciting day.
It was a long shot, too, I think. You were in that cab, and I mean, with the way the ownership was with Rupert, right? It was a long shot at that time, and if you look at this, the entire strategy, the art of war, whatever it was, to end up here, I don't know what you thought the initial chances are when you said, well, you know, Sky's pretty attractive. What do you think in your mind the initial chance of you succeeding were when you decided?
We knew
to do
the prize was worth it. I don't know what the percentage would be, but I learned from my father, if you don't try, you don't find out how it turns out. And if the worst that happens was we didn't prevail, even though it's tough on these kind of interviews, it's not how you build a great company. And we've been doing that for a lot of years. When we bought AT&T Broadband, even NBC Universal at the time raised a few eyebrows. I will say one of the things that heartens me the most is the reaction of the employees. If you think about it, the employees at Sky, the employees at NBC, and the employees at Comcast know this company better than any just casual part-time investor where you have a portfolio. This is all we do, and for most of us, it's where we have most of our net worth. The reaction from the employees is unlike any deal I've ever been part of. Maybe it's because it was a long shot. Maybe it's because it lasted a long time. I think it's more than that. I think it is the enthusiasm to take what they do, now be able to do it on a global scale, do it with the best in both continents. Comcast is number one at what we do with XFi and X1 and our great products. And NBC is now the number one broadcast network, first time in 16 years and been the fifth year and sixth year and since 18 to 49, but it's number one overall. And over at Sky, the number one brand in entertainment and communications. And to have all those parts to now lead into the future, it's transformative. Mm-hmm. And we're delighted here to have the kind of great results to show we can operate well and we have a great strategic road ahead.
Hey, Brian, let me ask you again about Wall Street reaction to some of these things. There are a number of analysts on the street who now either have buy or overweight ratings on Comcast, but they've raised some concerns, even some of those very same analysts who think that the street reaction by selling this was overdone. One analyst raised this question. He said that you paid a full multiple at the top of the cycle, and that's a deviation from the normal sort of acquisition that Comcast makes. What's your response to that? How do you answer that to say that it was worth it?
Well, you'll judge us in 20 years. I try to think the job for management is to put on earmuffs and try to do what you think is right. If you had a private company, you owned it all, what would you do if it was all your own money? Mm-hmm. And I think the employees, not just me, the senior leadership team, were all in that this was the right strategic move for the company at the right price. We were 10% higher bidder, as I said. I don't think that's a big gap. Again, to the point that was made, you had a 39% stockholder. You needed a margin to outbid the other folks. But what we're going to do this morning is introduce Jeremy and the Sky narrative for really the first time to American investors. It's not a stock that was widely followed over here. It did have a large shareholder, so it was a kind of been in takeover mode. They only put the three different countries together into one Sky in the last few years. And so Jeremy's going to take investors on our earnings call in a little bit this morning through a greater detail. And I think as the people get more educated and see the answers to the obvious questions of what about the change, how Sky positioned to continue to grow, they've grown every year they've been in business. That's basically the same truth for Comcast. They have the best product. We feel that's definitely the case here in the U.S. And the chemistry is off to a fabulous start. So it's one day at a time. There aren't always answers, but the good news is all that's behind us. Our priority is to get our balance sheet back at where it was as quickly as possible. That's the priority and focus now. Execute and get the debt to cash flow levels back to what they've historically been, and that's what we've told the rating agencies. So we know what our work ahead of us is. We're thrilled to have this opportunity, and so far, off to a great start. It's only been a month, so it's very, very early.